There's a Mel here in 25 minutes. First, though, if you're like me and a little bit bored with solitaire, it's time to spend some money on a new game. And here are the latest ones now on Cybernet.
This is Cybernet with me, Steve Truitt. On today's show, we've got some speedy heroes, some dancing Sims, a ferocious vampire, and a mighty gladiator. It's the all-powerful Cybernet. Let's get this show off to a speedy start with the fastest hedgehog in history. In fact, he's so quick that he managed to escape the obsolete Dreamcast console and race his way onto the GameCube, Xbox, and PlayStation 2. On your mark, get set, go with Sonic Heroes. Sonic has admittedly had some trouble venturing from his initial 2D style into a three-dimensional world. Fortunately, the developers at Sega have gone back to their roots, making an extremely fast-paced platform-hopping adventure. This new Sonic shares more similarities with the original title than any of his subsequent efforts. The most unique new feature is that you can now instantly switch between characters just like Mario Kart Double Dash. Only here, instead of having just two to select from, you get a team of three. Each has his special purpose. One's built for straight-ahead speed, another for pure strength, and finally, one who can fly. Choose wisely, because having the correct character at a specific point is the only way you'll advance. Of course, the emphasis is on frantic speed, and all the Sonic trademarks are here. You'll collect rings, bounce off strategically placed bumpers, and don't forget those famous dizzying loops. Sadly, some problems remain. While the graphics are colorful and distinctly Sonic, the single-player game is incredibly short. And there's still that erratic camera in the multiplayer mode, making you fall off track for no other reason than you can't see what's ahead of you. Also, while switching characters at any time is a cool feature, the action is far too fast for it. So when you choose the wrong one, you won't necessarily know what error you've made, leading you to repeat the same mistake. Even though it's hampered by several faults, Sonic Heroes is still among the best this series has produced. With a few improvements in the next sequel, our favorite hedgehog should be back on top, where he belongs. Batman is known for always being prepared for every possible situation. How does he do it? He has Cybernet helping him out. And now you do too. So grab a pen and jot down this cheat for Rise of Sinzu for the PlayStation 2. At the press start screen, while holding all four shoulder buttons, press down, up, left, right, left, and right. Holy preparedness, Batman! You've just unlocked everything in this game! That's right, now no matter what or who is threatening the city of Gotham, the Dark Knight has instantly got it covered. Sorry, evildoers, you're no match for this Caped Crusader. Last year, console owners jumped for joy when The Sims franchise finally made the transition from the PC. Now those quirky interactive people are back and busting out for more fun in their second console appearance on all three systems. Unlike previous Sims games that focused on a family, this edition has you concentrating on a single character. Naturally, the first thing you'll do is create your very own Sim. Hair, clothes, and even shoes can all be adjusted. You'll want to look your best because there are loads of new people to meet and places to visit. Fortunately, they provided you with a handy scooter so you can cruise the town in style. Although there's the usual emphasis on creativity and materialism, the primary goal this time is to seek your fame and fortune in an exciting career. You can be a mad scientist, gangster, or even a rock star. It's not an easy path to the top, though. You'll need to build skills and complete various objectives. And of course, practice. While he may not be ready for stardom, you can still keep your sim in high spirits with some basic caretaking. Always remember, a happy sim is a productive sim. So some food and a few trips to the facilities will do your sim a world of good. Be sure to concentrate on your job, though, because that's the only way you'll be able to build your dream house, as well as stop Malcolm Landgrab from stealing everything back from your mom. Bustin' Out is another fine addition to The Sims series. Navigating is still a bit clumsy, but the visual quality is noticeably improved. The environments have more detail, and the interface is a bit easier to use. It'll definitely keep fans satisfied until the highly anticipated Sims 2 is unveiled later this year. How does that sound to you?
It's Dola to think, and Shadu to think, Owegala too good to die.
Get ready for the adventure of a lifetime as an RPG giant makes its PlayStation 2 debut. There's strength in numbers, and these two brothers have teamed up to set out on a quest filled with mystery, magic, and plenty of danger. This is Ark the Lad, Twilight of the Spirits. Dark and Karg are brothers who join forces to gain control of the Great Spirit Stones. Throughout their mission, they'll face seemingly insurmountable odds while battling all sorts of unusual creatures. And the stakes are too high to lose because these siblings are the last hope to create a good and caring world. Fans of the Final Fantasy series should appreciate this complex storyline. Mysteries will unravel as you discover clues through strange and colorful environments. And your travels will take some time. With over 60 hours of gameplay, we bet fantasy fans with a taste for breathtaking visuals will have no problem immersing themselves in this world. You'll run into plenty of adversaries along the way, so raking up experience points is vital. The combat is turn-based, creating a virtual chessboard that requires you to make the right decisions in the heat of battle. And as you progress, you'll be able to utilize up to 14 different characters, each having their own unique abilities, weapons, and special combination attacks. While Ark the Lad, Twilight of the Spirits offers nothing innovative to the genre, it does have some impressive qualities. Although it may seem a bit outdated when compared to more polished titles like Final Fantasy X2 and Knights of the Old Republic, we think true RPG fans will enjoy this fantastical experience. Buckle up, it's time to unleash Cybernet's top 10 favorite racing games. At number 10, flying through the air with the greatest of ease, it's the adventurous aviators of Freaky Flyers soaring on the Xbox and PS2. These Hot Wheels may be small, but in Highway 35 World Race on the PC, GameCube, and PS2, the stunts are big at 9. At 8, pushing us past the speed limit, it's the two-wheeled craziness of XGRA Extreme G Racing Association on all consoles. This brave bandicoot and his wacky pals recklessly roll into 7 with Crash Nitro Kart on the GameCube, Xbox, and PS2. At 6, get off the sidewalks because this driving is out of control with the tire-squealing antics of Midtown Madness 3 on the Xbox. In our 5th spot, here's a racer that defies gravity on the GameCube. It's the white-knuckle ride of a lifetime, F-Zero GX. Floating to number 4, the racing is getting wet and wild as we soar over the surf in Splashdown 2, making waves on the PS2. You'll have to go underground to satisfy your need for speed as our number 3 pick crashes onto the PC and all consoles. The famous plumber and all his friends are taking turns behind the wheel in Mario Kart Double Dash on the GameCube at 2. But it's those beautiful cars and gorgeous locations that make Project Gotham Racing 2 on the Xbox our number one racer. Remember these? More importantly, remember the fun games we old-timers used to play on them? While you can't relive the past, you can visit it via the Xbox and PS2. This time, though, you can leave your bucket of coins behind with Midway Arcade Treasures. Before cel-shaded graphics and 3D technology were commonplace, kids flocked to the neighborhood arcade to play these memorable titles. This collection includes over 20 classic games, resulting in a nostalgic look back at the entertainment we had from years past. Naturally, the one that revolutionized the industry, Defender, is included. Here you'll pilot your spaceship in a side-scrolling adventure while blasting a never-ending supply of aliens. Hang on to your seat, the original Spy Hunter lets you get behind the wheel of one of the coolest cars ever. Watch out for the cops along the way, though. Other fan favorites include Paperboy, which puts you on a bicycle, delivering the daily newspapers to people's houses, and Root Beer Tapper, where the goal is to keep all your thirsty customers happy by keeping their mugs filled. Watch out if they make it to the end of the bar, though. And let's not forget Rampage, the original giant monster mayhem game. The disc also includes some DVD extras. You'll learn the game's origins through developer interviews and uncover some top secret stuff. Who needs Tony Hawk with these cool skaters? Midway Arcade Treasures is a fantastic look back at some early classics of video gaming. You may have to get used to playing these titles without a joystick, but it is surely worth it. We all could use a little help when playing Empires: Dawn of the Modern World on the PC. After all, global domination isn't as easy as it used to be. Luckily, the mighty conqueror Cybernet is here to lend a hand. So grab a pen and jot this cheat down. Press Enter to bring up the chat interface and type in the word noob. That's N-O-O-N-B. You've been given an enormous cheat because we've just revealed the entire map, removed the fog of war, given you 10,000 resource points, and instantly trained all your units and finished your buildings. That's right, Cybernet is the only place you need for great tactics. So, enjoy. Coming up, a dangerous battle, a victorious gladiator, and a gruesome legacy.
The 24-hour quiz has begun.
And we're live here on ITV1.
Giving you the chance to win thousands of pounds every day.
The quizmates must live, eat, and even sleep together whilst desperately trying to win all that lovely cash.
I am so excited.
Call this number now to get on the show.
Anybody can play for a place inside the pod.
And remember,
once you're in, you start to win. This is the 24-hour quiz.
Weekdays from 2:30, ITV1 and 2.
On or off the pitch, it's all about balls.
That's the game, boss.
You've either got them...
You're up to your eyes in it, Frank. We'd like to buy you out.
Get stuffed!
Or you don't.
I'm dropping it, Kyle.
And when the ladies play, there's no offside rules.
Just you and me, yeah?
I'm sure it doesn't count if it's not on dry land. I don't have to call for assistance.
No, that's just filthy talk.
New series, Footballers' Wives, Wednesday at 9, ITV1.
Welcome back to part two of Cybernet. begin this half with an impossible mission. Can a band of gun-toting rebels pull off the biggest heist of all time in the middle of a war? Bring plenty of ammunition, because we're gonna find out if four heavily armed and dangerous thieves can make it happen on the PC and Xbox. There are four members of the group who collectively are known as the Lionhearts. You'll play as Roman, the team leader, and you'll be assisted by an odd-looking mole man, a British robot, and a stinky little blind mystic. Their goal is to steal the all-powerful Book of Rule from the evil King Forge.
What are you talking about?
I am talking about the ultimate heist. I'm talking about giving King Forge a swift kick to the...
Oh, please, cut to the chase!
For the most part, Armed and Dangerous is a straightforward third-person shooter that takes you through 21 missions spread across five different landscapes. On your way to the King's Lair, you'll battle a slew of wicked enemies like half-man, half-animal grunts, Eliminator droids, and wall-smashing Goliaths. And don't worry if you happen to miss with a grenade, the environments are very interactive. While the maps and level design are rather ordinary, the arsenal is among the most unique we've ever seen. Sure, they've got a rocket launcher and machine gun, but there's also a whole range of other super cool, over-the-top weapons, like the black hole bomb, and a topsy-turvy bomb that turns the world upside down. The best, though, is the Land Shark Launcher, which causes a shark to swim under the ground surface and attack an enemy from below. Along with bashing bad guys, you'll also need to rescue some helpless villagers and cruise around in a jetpack. These help break up the pace and add some variety, but for the most part, the missions are somewhat repetitive and mundane. And while the explosions look good, the majority of the graphics are bland and a bit muddy. Although it's somewhat limited, Armed and Dangerous is a solid shooter with responsive controls and plenty of frantic action. There's rarely a dull moment, which is perfect for those who want a simple but fun blast fest. Ever wish you were taller? There's no denying the advantage of towering over your enemies in a ruthless fight. And that's why Cybernet has gathered this fast-acting miracle growth potion. All you need to do is grab a pen and jot it down for Dungeon Siege Legends of Arana on the PC. Press enter and type in plus max juki as one word. That's the plus sign, then M-A-X-J-O-O-K-N-Y. How's the weather up there? Get used to hearing that question, because we've just made you a giant. That's right, while this doesn't make you any stronger, we believe that bigger is definitely better. Enjoy. Nearly every modern sport has already been transformed into a video game, so it was only a matter of time before developers went backwards in time for inspiration. Behold, Gladiator Sword of Vengeance for the PC, Xbox, and PlayStation 2. The setting is the Roman Empire of the ancient past. Here you play as the warrior slave Invictus Thrax. He's been chosen by the gods to dethrone Arruntius, because this evil king has turned the entire countryside into a giant gladiator coliseum. The story is a blend of history and mythology. This means Thrax will have to use every muscle in his body to defeat soldiers, fellow gladiators, a slew of gigantic monsters, and even a few foes who've returned from the land of the dead. As you progress, you'll acquire powerful weapons. And just like in real life, the more you practice with them, the better your skills will become. So before you know it, you'll have the experience necessary to take on multiple opponents, making even Conan the Barbarian jealous. And while our hero may not have a great sense of style, his creativity in dispatching his foes is evident. In fact, the flashier he is with the sword, the more violent the action gets. The fighting engine, mixed with a large menu of weapons and combos, keeps the gameplay from getting too repetitive. However, those looking for a little more strategy and challenge might find this simple run straight and attack concept somewhat disappointing. Still, Gladiator is a sword-swinging good time with rich graphics, an engrossing story, and plenty of action sure to quench even the most bloodthirsty appetite. To quote the great Maximus himself, are you not entertained? Next up, it's the king of extreme, Tony Hawk, who's starring in our Game of the Week. This time, though, the skateboarding whiz is going underground on all three consoles. While Mr. Hawk is best known for revolutionizing the sport of skateboarding, he's reached an entirely new level of stardom thanks to his trend-setting series. And happily, for this fifth edition, the development team has done more than simply add a few new levels and slap a number 5 at the end of the title. Instead, they decided to put a whole new spin on the franchise. Perhaps the biggest surprise is that skaters can now jump off their board and run across rooftops or hop over steps. This allows you to start tricks from some formerly out-of-reach locations. You'll also be able to drive a car. That's right, certain missions ask you to cruise through town. These driving sections are a little clunky, but they're still fun and a good change of pace. Another major change is the inclusion of a story mode. You begin as a street punk learning the ropes in your local New Jersey neighborhood. By completing objectives and impressing the right people, you'll get sponsored and eventually become a big-time professional skater. So now you'll have a reason for risking life and limb as you pull off these crazy combos, as if you needed one. Although this edition boasts several key modifications, the primary attraction is still the amazing array of stunts. Nearly everything you see can be tricked off of and grinded on, so you're only limited by your imagination, or lack of coordination. The animations are realistic, the controls are responsive, and the environment's huge. All the multiplayer games are fantastic, especially one called Firefight, which allows players to shoot fireballs. Underground is another stellar addition in the Tony Hawk series. We're thrilled to see the developers take a few chances, and that's why it's our Game of the Week. Get ready now for a game that puts the bite back into adventure. The long-running Legacy of Kain series has won legions of fans while spawning the successful spin-off series Blood Omen. Now, characters from both series join forces for the ultimate struggle of good versus evil in Defiance for the Xbox and PS2. In its fifth installment, you play as both the tortured heroic wraith Raziel and Kain, the ferocious vampire whose morals are somewhat ambiguous. Each has their own combat method that usually results in the life force being drained from their enemies. There's some over-the-top violence, which may not be suitable for kids, but everyone else will be treated to some brilliant, highly detailed graphics that beautifully set a gothic mood. It's the story that has drawn fans back again and again to these characters. Defiance continues this ongoing tale, but also serves as a perfect introduction for those new to the series. Here, both heroes seek to change their destinies. Kain wishes to take his place as Balance Guardian, while Raziel strives to free his sword from the dreaded Reaver Blade. The combat engine is greatly improved from the previous edition, allowing both characters to showcase their fierce styles. A major highlight is using Kain's magical powers. Here he uses an invisible force spell to throw a battalion of guards over the side of a bridge. It just goes to show, when you're crossing a bridge and see a vampire on the other end, go the other way. This is a pretty straightforward beat-em-up that should please gamers who miss traditional side-scrollers like the original Castlevania. While it may not be for everybody, Legacy of Kain Defiance has enough surprises to drive longtime fans batty with excitement. It looks like it's time for us to fly our way out of here. Cybernet will be back soon, though, with more great video game reviews. And don't forget to keep in touch via email. So until we meet again, here's more magical moments from Beyond Good and Evil, compliments of Cybernet.